Welcome, everybody. Today will be Camden County versus Manchester University playing for Overwatch today. Stream will be starting soon in just a moment. But yeah, sit back and get ready. Welcome back, everybody. First match is just starting. Looks like the Cougars are running Orisa, Symmetra, Sojourn, Zen, and Lucio. We're seeing those Symmetra turrets go out. Orisa getting very aggressive here. Same with their Sojourn.
And not to startle the viewing audience, but I've also popped in here with Aiden. So Aiden, here we go. I mean, like you said, map number one, getting ready to get started, and already first blood.
That was a great block by Pikachu, absolutely saving him from that turret. He's holding on for dear life right now, fighting this tank, and he gets the kill. And the Cougars will take sight.
They will, and it was first blood that actually went over to Manchester, but it was the win, the team fight win went over to Camden County. So typically you don't see that, right? In Overwatch, you drop that first kill, and then suddenly it kind of cascades from there. But the Cougars able to right the ship, take the first control point.
Yeah, it does look like they are going to try to retake from the side though, instead of doing a head-on push. You see all of them kind of grouping up. You are seeing that Zen Discord absolutely melt that health away. Speaking of Shanks holding back as well as he can.
Pair of kills, but absolutely it's going to be Manchester bouncing right back. So you like to, I mean, you would want to hold on to the site a little bit longer than that. 35%, right? Not that strong of an early showing. I mean, you always take a win. You always want to be counting that percent up in your control point, but 35, like I said, just really means that you have won that initial team fight. So the Cougars will look to bounce back here.
are going to see a bunch of wolves start popping up. This is the first one going out. As we can see, it is just back and forth wolves right now. We might see a flank here. Tank getting very good damage. Tank goes down.
Tank going down.
Tank getting pinned to the wall.
This might be an opportunity now for Camden.
The last supports and DPS trying to hold the site, but Pika Shakes is just not letting him stay on.
And honestly, they don't really have to, does Manchester, right? I mean, look at the ult economy. There are four across the board, so it's going to be a big team fight coming up here in just a few moments, you'd like to think.
And that Zenil is going to come especially in handy, trying to counter all four of those ults. See it go out, along with the special ult.
Huge pick from Pika Shakes to get us started.
Sojourn pick right there.
Oh man, Jaehyun going so low, by the way, 9 HP, but as we've seen, he comes in clutch.
Absolutely shredding with that ultimate. Great counter from the Cougars. Manchester is going to be waiting for their tank to come back before making their second push. Well, the Cougars are getting up their percentage. I don't know if Manchester will have time to come back. Gotta get over there quick.
Well, they're going to have to get this team fight win for sure. Can't afford to lose another. And of course, the Orisa does have ultimate.
Great stall. Looks like they might try to use it. They are pulling everybody off of site and getting a pick on one of their healers.
The Cougars just cleaning things up here. Just a few stragglers from Manchester left on site, and that's all it will take.
You can see they're struggling to get this Lucio off the walls.
The spear, just this shield causing some havoc. Just enough for Manchester to get back to the site for just a moment. And Jaehyun has fallen, so this is it. They're not out of it just yet.
And another one is back. They are absolutely holding this site. They did not want to get overtime over, but unfortunately, they go down.
Oh man, it got a little bit dicey there. The Lucio just skating across of the top of the control point. But they lock him down. Lock him down, lock up round number one.
Great round from the Cougars, absolutely doing a great job holding their site, especially with that Orisa. That block just absolutely pushes everybody back along with that spear. They're going to see them swap up to Ramattra on the side of Manchester.
I count on you.
And it looks like the Cougars are sticking with the same kind of team comp. Second match has started. Cougars getting up early, trying to get that site hold.
By the way, seeing a couple of players, Defiant Human and Dead Drop, that we haven't seen from Camden County just yet, so some slightly different play styles coming out as Dead Drop the first to fall, but they trade right back.
We're going to see a bunch of trades going out. That Ramattra is absolutely shredding right now. Unfortunately, gets picked off.
And that is huge.
Orisa and Lucio back. Lucio almost gets one.
And it's a moment a couple of pixels away with Slat from getting maybe one or two off the side there. Now Pika Shanks surely going to have to wait for the reinforcements, and they have arrived.
Unfortunately, gets taken down. Adjusting third placement. You saw the Symmetra TP'd onto the, both Symmetras actually TP'd onto the top of the site so they could both get there fast. Just a matter of, you know, a bit of holds the site better. It was just unfortunate that Ramattra got to pick off that healer, so they did not have the heals to keep up with Manchester. I see a... I could have taken sight. Pika Shanks can hear the Lucio kind of riding the walls up there. Symmetra is set up with all their turrets.
Almost gets a pick, just Jaehyun so close!
Zen Discord trying to put in that work. Pika Shanks is going to make a push on the site. Getting shredded by those Symmetra turrets, though.
Just trying to find some heals. Yeah.
We're trying to push back out. They are going to Lucio ult.
Lucio ult does come out, as you pointed out, but it doesn't yield much. Cougars just struggling to find any sort of avenue onto the control point. And with the tank down, they're going to have to rethink the attack.
Manchester is looking at a lot of ults right now.
Oh, and this would be a huge pick.
The Hoon does manage to get the tank. Will they be able to get any more picks to try to push them off the site while both tanks are down?
Of course, Camden County's tank will be back to this site before Manchester, so there's going to be a small opportunity.
A great retake from the Cougars. Tae-Hoon getting those great picks.
Wow, and they were insane, those picks. I mean, and it was that pick onto the tank, just giving an extra moment for Camden County to have that plus advantage was huge, and Tae-Hoon able to capitalize.
Yeah, their tank got a little bit too aggressive, and their healers just could not catch up with the DPS, you know, kind of picking off their healers and then eventually picking off their tank.
But looking at the percentages here, Aiden, they're going to have to play perfect. Camden County really can't afford to even lose one team fight, so they're going to have to win two or three, and an ultimate does come down.
We're going to see a Zendel on the Cougars soon. Pikachu's absolutely knocking one of their DPS off the map, which is huge.
It's going to short-circuit that attack before it even really gets a chance to get started.
You see, everybody's kind of just farming ults right now and trying to get their percentages up. It's going to be very hard to counter an Orisa and a Zendel at the same time. And they also have Lucio ults.
Dead drop getting a little bit aggressive. Of course, they're able to teleport back. I kind of like this the Symmetra ultimate here. Or excuse me, teleporter. This ends now.
It's going to be pretty difficult, because right now it's seeming that the Cougars are kind of immortal. Unfortunately, both of their healers go down.
Yeah, and that's two supports.
They unfortunately did not see that TP, and the Ramattra is ulted on site. Kikashik's trying to hold his ground, but he unfortunately cannot. That was a good Symmetra TP by them. Absolutely got behind them and got rid of both of their healers, which was what needed to be done.
A massive play from Manchester.
I mean, intense matches right now.
For sure, for sure. I mean, both teams definitely evenly matched. A pick or two is really the difference here so far. So this is the decider in map number one. Of course, everybody, it is a best of five series. So we are just waiting to see who will strike first in this one.
We are going to see a DPS switch up on both teams, and a tank switch up as well. Pikachu's switching up to that D.Va, and they're also going Tracer now as well. Plus, the Manchester's going Junkrat instead of Symmetra.
And the Cougars just put themselves in a situation in the last round where, again, they just had to play a little bit too perfect. So they're look to see them have a stronger opening here.
Projectiles. Tracer going in for the flank, trying to get some of their DPS out.
He does draw the aggro, but doesn't get a kill, but there is zero. The tank is down.
Unfortunately, gets traded.
And Pikachu's out. Yeah, he's out of the mech right now, so he's going to have to build that back.
Junkrat does go down. Dead drop. His health is down. How is he alive?
This D.Va mech isn't back yet, so again, effectively, no tank right now for Camden County.
They're going to see their Lucio get a little bit aggressive trying to get rid of that D.Va.
Mech does come back, but the percent counts up for Manchester.
They did hatch off the Zarya, which is very deadly against D.Va, because that shield means absolutely nothing now. We're going to see an ult go out from Slat. Being very aggressive against our Lucio, almost getting the pick, but just that Ana is just, that Ana's heal is just absolutely nuts.
But Slat does get the kill onto Zero. Of course, we still see the Junkrat, the double kill.
DPS too. Cougars are gonna have to make a hell of a hole to keep point.
They are controlling the point right now, so another pick here would be huge. Pikachu's still alive. Self-destruct will give him some space.
No picks, unfortunately. One support does go down. Pikachu getting pretty aggressive. Holding behind that wall, we do see a Tracer roll. He might go for the flank.
definitely had a little angle there, at least for a moment. Pikachu's now off the board, mech and all.
You're gonna see that anti hit three of them, and it's just what Manchester needed to push them all off of sight. You're gonna see a swap through Matra. Pikachu getting very aggressive against their tank. Waiting for his heals before you can push back in.
They do get the pick, but we've seen this. Manchester bouncing right back every time they drop one. They're getting plus advantage here, and they get another three.
It goes out. Gets three picks. Pikachu's unable to hold. That Zarya is just deadly when she has her beam fully charged. I see Jaehoon trying to get some damage in. Best to kind of stay back right now and have that Zarya beam pulled down before pushing in again. We're going to see another jungle come out. Unfortunately, it gets two again.
It got two, you're right. And that's three, no, two down right now. And the Cougars are just folding.
Looks like the first match is going to go to Manchester.
No, you're absolutely right. 1-0 Camden County now. Down in this one, but it's a long way to go here. It's a best of five, the first of three, so a few more.
We're going to see a play of the game from Jaehoon onto the Sojourn. A great play, comboing that ult with the just to kind of drag everybody in so he can kill everyone.
All right, so there we have it, Aiden. Map one done. Map two underway. What did you see in that one that kind of jumps off the screen, so to speak?
They both were very intense. It just came down to the matter of Manchester swapped the players they needed to, unfortunately. And it was kind of hard to come back to counter for Cougars. By that time, it was kind of too late.
Yeah, I mean, we saw them. Yeah, maybe the adjustments, I think, for Manchester a little bit stronger than they were for Camden. Listen, Camden now needs to make that adjustment mid-map. So we'll have map two in just a little while, everybody, so stay tuned. All right, welcome back. Map 2 getting started here. Camden County versus Manchester University.
We are going to see a very good-looking team comp from the Cougars. Mika Shinks on the Sigma, Dead Drop on the Ash, Jaehoon on the Soldier, Mehan and on the Mercy, and Slat on the Brig. Manchester still looking for their other support class, and it looks like we are going to see a Baptiste. Nice. Pretty similar team comp from the last game from Manchester.
1. Attackers incoming.
You see the cougars kind of getting a good hold up right now.
The barrier is weakened.
I'm gonna see Sigma, which is a hard gunner to Bastion. You see they're all kind of flying back right now, getting that damage in from up above. Meanwhile, the Sigma's down there throwing rocks. We're gonna see that Sigma absolutely tank that whole Bastion ability. Completely backing them off.
Low health bars, but no kills yet gained by either team. And as I say that, the tank goes down, Jaehyun on the soldier.
That damage boost on Mercy is so good when you're playing either soldier or Bastion or anybody with that kind of like rapid hit fire.
Barrier is nearly spent.
And Manchester wisely going to back up here. Don't need to keep banging your head against the wall here without a tank. They're going to wait for the whole squad and they will look to re-engage as Dead Drop goes so low but lives.
They're going to see another Sigma go up instead of Remaka now. Unfortunately, both DPS get picked off by the soldier that jumped up. They're going to see a res.
A huge res. Of course, Mejia now in the game.
Slat trying to hold his ground, but unfortunately getting pushed by the tank and DPS. They are swapping to Orisa.
Objective.
Manchester capturing the point and now switching to payload. It's gonna get real hectic once those castle wards drop. We're gonna see some Ulsar pop up from both sides, actually. We're gonna see a Sentinel and a Soldier roll. Like they have swapped from Baptiste to Lucio on the side of Manchester. They're Bastion trying to get a flank, but Dead Drop catches him in the act. Dead Drop might go down here.
Definitely will. I don't think there's any way. I'm amazed he's still alive.
Jaehyun up on holding the castle right now, getting a great pick.
Pikachu is in an awkward position here alone. Of course, there's no support around. Dead Drop res, but only for a moment. Oh, I take that back. It is still alive.
We're going to see that Sinnoh go out on the side of Manchester. See, they're getting scared with that Soldier ult. Unfortunately, gets taken down by that Zen. That Discord Orb is so deadly. What a great pick from Dead Drop onto that Zen. That burn can be so deadly as well.
The Cougars a little disjointed, though, I think, right now, Aiden. I mean, they seem to be all over the place. Some players making some individual plays, but as a unit, seem to be possibly, like I said, a little bit just not quite on the same page.
Sure, they almost have payload onto the point. They're going to give him a lot of time.
Well, he does bait out the Lucio ultimate.
You're going to see them swap to Bastion. That Bastion absolutely shred along with Pikachu's ult getting two.
Well, they will be able to put the brakes on this push, but I mean, for the first couple of minutes of this map, Manchester looked very comfortable.
We are seeing a lot of counters right now. That Sigma is just going to absolutely eat up those Soldier, Bastion, and Orisa bullets. Bastion ult's going out.
I'm not sure where it's going to come
from. On the flank.
They are pushing on the flank here. They've gotten behind, but the tank, Pikachu's, has responded.
You're going to see a solo ult onto the Mercy. Does not kill her, though. That Zen, though, is just absolutely shredding while the team is distracted. You're going to see the rest of the team come up from behind. That tank play from Manchester was a great bait to split up the team and get them focused on different things.
3 minutes and 30 seconds, which is plenty of time for this final push.
You're gonna see a tank swap again. The Sigma ability is not there for the Bastion. You're gonna see a swap to Far as well, which seems like a great idea as he's gotten one and almost two picks. great play here from Jehu, controlling those skies right now. They're all kind of hiding back. Bastion's trying to get it to picks, but it's just unable to peek solo without any heals.
Camden's Bastion ult comes out here, finds two! No, just the one!
I see a pick on the Bastion here, and it is pushing Manchester back. Kuja are going to be able to push the payload back a little bit here.
They are. Three ultimates on the side of Manchester, so this next team fight will look to be pivotal. The Cougars have shown us flashes on this map here, Aiden, but again, it's hesitant. Where's that sustained success and opportunity here to build just that?
2 minutes left on the clock here. They are going to have Faro soon, which is going to be a great counter.
Jehun definitely going to have to be mindful of his health bar. Does get into a flanking position. And there he goes, found two.
Gets the one. The Fin pick is honestly a great pick out of anybody he could have killed. Stops that Discord orb from going out, but it looks like they are unfortunately getting picked off. We're going to see a res. Might be huge. Jehun getting a double pick.
Wow, that rocket AoE. Proving to be instrumental now.
And he's getting pocketed by the Mercy, making him unkillable right now.
Pocket Mercy, not something we've seen a whole lot since when I played Overwatch back in the day, honestly.
Still see it occasionally, but not as much. You're gonna see Manchester struggling a little bit. Zenult's going out.
Zenult's gonna keep the push going. Jehun off the board, at least for the moment.
1 minute on the clock. Can the Cougars hold it? Pikachu's getting walled off, unfortunately. They're gonna see them try to res, but unfortunately, they are not gonna be able to hold long enough. A good try from the Cougars, holding down that fort, but unfortunately, Manchester was just saving up their ultimate to kind of dump them all at the last minute. Switching sides. Initiating. See if we have any team comp switch-ups.
As we get ready to see what that team composition will look like for both squads, just a good opportunity to pause for some station identification, as if this was the radio. Camden County College Cougar Esports, everybody, thanks so much for watching. If you're interested in esports production, we're still looking, obviously always looking for more students to sign up and enroll. Be just like Aiden here. Everybody here, if you're interested in competition, I'd love to hear from you as well. And Dendrop with the switch to is that Symmetra? Am I crazy?
That's Sombra.
Sombra. Symmetra is the teleporting player. Gotcha. I'll get it.
We are seeing Sombra this match. It looks like Manchester's kind of sticking the same. They are going to swap to Mei, though. I think they realized how big that wall is to kind of split off their tank. We're going to see the side of the Cougars go back to Ramattra. Try to go for more of an aggressive team. He did swap from Sombra back to Tracer. We'll see how that goes.
The Tracer came out in map one. They saw some damage. Nothing, not any really huge plays, but I kind of like Tracer, at least to start here. Can you certainly get behind enemy lines, get some flanks.
It might have seen him cross, but we'll see in a second. Like Manchester's kind of doing the same kind of hold, having their Sojourn go up top and the rest kind of stay down at the bottom.
Low health bars, dead drop goes down, slat low as well.
See that shield that absolutely melts.
Manchester not taking a very aggressive defense here, and as I say that, the Mei gets a kill on Jehun.
Almost melting away that Matra. Looks like he's going to try to flank around from the side and try to get him. Mei is extremely deadly with that wall, blocking off any heals on the Pikachu.
I mean, the one thing that I'm noticing here, Manchester, if you recall, after they lost their tank, after they lost some players, they backed away. Camden County continues to kind of push in here, which can just get you into a spot where you're just never really recovered.
For sure. We are seeing Manchester play more of like a counter push kind of play. As soon as Camden kind of gets that momentum going, they just kind of build a wall and get that one pick, and then the Cougars kind of have to back off a little bit. We're gonna see Deadrop going with that Tracer. We're gonna see a Mauga come in, which is a new unit, or not unit, character that came out recently.
And Zero goes low, but stays alive, and that's really all that matters. May will go into her ice block here.
He's gonna get absolutely shredded though as he gets walled off from his team. We're gonna see a swap up to Kiriko, which would be great to get rid of that Zen Orb, because that Zen Orb Discord is just absolutely what's causing them problems right now. We're gonna see them swap back to Bastion. Mauga Bastion is a deadly combo, you know, people's health gets absolutely shred away. He's gonna almost get a pick. Both their supports just pushing back Mega Shinx.
Zen ult popped as well, so the Cougars are all in and they have to.
Both Zen ults went out. We are gonna see Jehoon with the ult. Does manage to get the trade on himself.
It's a close fight, a number of kills from both sides.
And we are gonna see a Mauga ult counter that May ult. Will he survive it? Looks like he might.
Still alive, but looking for some heals.
He gets picked off, and he gets picked off as well. Sojourn comes in to help the May on one HP. Bastion does get a pick on the Sojourn, with Kiriko back to help.
Trying to get out healed here.
Got Orisa health, just the Bastion could not keep up. Unfortunate.
And the Cougars will have to start from square one.
See their Mauga get a bit aggressive. Walled off again, unfortunately, and gets picked off. We see a four assist kill. And the Cougars slowly get picked off. That male that's screwing him over right now, just walling off their tank solo and then not able to get any heals.
Yeah, Pikachu goes in again, but with that May wall, like you pointed out, Aiden, there's just no hope. No, the supports can't get to him. And that will be it. Map 2 goes the way of Manchester.
Gotta play the game here. You are gonna see a Zen play the game from Slat.
So Camden County getting the play of the game, two maps in a row that they lost. So again, individual performances coming out, Aiden, but not the win, which is really all that matters.
That was a really good Mauga ult to kind of try to hold that side. It's just unfortunate that their May got away on one HP.
All right, so yeah, we're map 2 finished, heading now into map 3. The Cougars will need to win all 3 of these next maps to win the night. Totally possible. We've seen it before. And I think in a game like Overwatch, again, it's not really an economic-based game. You reset every time. And we have, there's like a few Camden County players we haven't seen yet. I imagine that we may see them here in the map 3 with their backs up against it. So we'll see what happens. Yeah, map 3 coming up. Don't go anywhere. All right, welcome back, everybody. Camden County College, Cougar Esports. The score up top does not reflect it, but I can promise you that Manchester is up 2-0. Aiden, they will need to win 3 here to win the night. So we do, as we take a look at both teams here, what's jumping off the page?
We are having 2 new players on the side of Camden. We're having Axiv and Candle Queen. Very interesting plays. They're going Reaper and Hamster.
A little bit different from what we had seen. Of course, we had seen a little bit more.
What a great slam right there.
Absolutely phenomenal. And it yields a kill on the backside, and Candle Queen is just being heavily disrupted.
It's like flying with that hamster. Oh my god, dude. That was a great slam. It got through everybody up in the air and allowed their whole team to get hit. Especially this Lucio trying to hold his ground. I don't think he could be able to. Gets knocked off of sight and then taken out. What a play. We are seeing Candle Queen go off right now.
Yeah, absolutely amazing there. And it looks like the Cougars might get another pick here. It looked like for a moment, but I guess Slats just being a little disruptive. Doesn't, of course, have that DPS playing, but Lucio backs up.
That Mercy as well, that damage boost, just helping them shred away their health. There's he has a tank swap of my thing. Swapping from D.Va to Junker Queen. Trying to push out, but just gets shredded away. That Reaper shredding both of their support. Almost getting a DPS as well, and their tank. Getting res.
Axiv right back in it. And whenever we see Mejia play the Mercy, of course, that does give that advantage, right? Where you can always get that player back.
We see Candle Queen just chasing down that Soldier, getting that pick. We're seeing them being a lot more confident now since from last match.
Oh, a different team, no doubt. They've hit Manchester in the mouth here. There's no question about it.
See Candle Queen kind of sitting here waiting. Let's see where he can kind of grapple up and get at that great land again for next point. Jaehoon, get some early damage in, wait for the rest of the team to kind of push up. There's see Candle Queen try to get a little bit of a flank going in.
What I like for the Cougars team comp here is there's a lot of mobility, right? I mean, you have just a lot of speed and a lot of ways to just make up ground. Candle Queen getting a little aggressive there. They trade tanks, but it's Axiv with another kill. And the Zenyatta has gone low, he is down, and the Cougars look to turn this one, but
Candle Queen's gonna get rest again, and they're gonna have their tank back, which is a huge advantage. Allowing them to take that point. They are gonna swap to Orisa. It looks like Manchester's kind of struggling with this hamster ball.
And now, if you're Manchester, you have to rethink things a little bit. I feel like, you know, maps 1 and 2, you got used to a certain lineup. Map 3 is a completely different squad. And now, what do you do?
Seeing Axiv and Candle Queen play really well off each other. We see Candle Queen go in, get most of that damage in, and tank most of that so that Axiv can come in after and basically play cleanup crew and get all those picks. We're gonna see them swap to.
We do see the Winston, of course, coming out of here, right? And Axiv has that ultimate ready. Goes low.
Mercy of Bastion will go out. Are not able to hack him in time.
Oh, he's just hunting, trying to get this pick. Family Guy and the Zenyatta does go down.
We're gonna see this Sombra ult go out. Great ult from Slad, absolutely saving his whole team.
Both his whole team and himself. He was down to almost, I think it was under 20 HP.
And here comes Axiv with the cleanup crew.
Flashpoint 2 in the pocket of Camden County. And they have looked very aggressive, looked very confident to your point, Aiden. They are definitely on the front foot here in map 3.
You can definitely see when a team's struggling, when they're trying to keep swapping around characters, you know, try to find that good kind of counter push, but it just Manchester's not able to find it right now.
Yeah,
his mobility team
answers
is too much for them to handle.
They do have a number of ultimates, so now would be the time if you're Manchester, you want to find something. They do have the Cougars here in a choke point. The Cougars will look to get off to the side. Candle Queen does go down, so this might be the opportunity that Manchester needs.
They're going to see two deadly ults go on the side of Camden. Side of Manchester, they kind of hold, getting their pitch that they need, but they're kind of wasting their ults on, when the team's kind of soloed off by themselves. We're gonna see Camden kind of sit back and wait for them to group up together, and then they're gonna make that final push in.
Smart play for sure. They were, as you said, going in one at a time. Not really the look that you want to see. Certainly not in Overwatch. So now they are gonna group up together. Candle Queen gonna look for a bit of a flank here.
They're gonna see him tank a bunch of damage and then sneak away after.
But Slack gets that kill onto the Zenyatta!
And he's pushing the DPS back to allow his team to push up. Jaehoon does unfortunately get picked off.
But Jaehoon right back into it. The Mercy res comes out and the Cougars look to turn this fight.
Some are ultimating out, but they're getting picked.
It's a messy fight ultimately. The Winston ult is wreaking havoc here, but he's goes awfully low and he's down.
Solo Winston ult is just unfortunate. You can't really do anything. You need some kind of damage boost to go with it, either with Mercy or like a Zen to kind of counteract with it.
So Zenyatta going down early in that fight is really the key for me. So Zenyatta will still have ult heading into this, what could be final team fight of this flashpoint.
This is gonna be very hard for Manchester to kind of come back here. We're seeing five ults from the side of Camden. They did a good job of kind of holding back their ults. Obviously to save it for this last final push so they could grab this last point and get first point over the offset of Cougars.
When will these teams utilize ultimates? Candle Queen goes the low, active down.
See Mercy go back and get that res.
Huge
like
res.
Overwatch 1, 66 with a Mercy on their team. Just constant reses.
They need to bounce back one for one right now, Aiden, as they look to try and finish this team fight. Axiom teleporting away! Kind of wild in the midst of a team fight.
And there he goes. Cougars absolutely annihilating Manchester. As we're seeing, those two new players just come in and absolutely destroy it. I mean, I'd be pretty annoyed if I had that hamster kind of push me out of the way off of site. We're going to see a play of the game from Jaehoon here on Sojourn, as usual.
Yeah, it's a sight that we've seen quite a bit, right? Oh, and there it was on a Cobra Master. The Cobra Maestro.
Lined up.
I mean, listen, by Jaehoon's standards, I've seen better. I mean, I'm just gonna say, it was, I mean, a pretty short map, honestly, right? I mean, I think that, and if you're Manchester, you have to be a little bit kind of, like I said, confused, right? Map one, okay, it started off shaky, you close that out. Map two, decisively in your hand. Map three, going completely the opposite direction. So, I mean, what do you have to say about that, Aiden? What did you see?
Well, we saw Manchester trying to do what they did in the first and second map, try to, you know, counteract with different team comps, but that tank alone was just switching and he couldn't find a good counter. So it'll be interesting to see how they come into this next map, for sure.
All right, so we'll see if any lineups change on either squad as we head into map four. Again, the Cougars looking to win map four to force a map five. Manchester trying to lock it down. So stay tuned for map four coming up in just a minute.
Oh, you know.
To the fourth match. Camden only needs two more. Meanwhile, this is match point for Manchester. We're going to see this almost the same. Axiom switching the Widow and Jaehyun going back to that Sojourn.
Love to see Axiom on the Widow. It's one of the signature selections for Noah. Playing those sniping characters, it's between the Widow and the Hanzo. So it's another Feast or Famine character, though, Aiden. You know, if you're hitting your shots, it's going to look great. But if you're whiffing, and there, yes, we didn't see it. But you'll have to take my word for it. First Blood goes over to Camden County.
Actually, as you said, I mean, if your aim is crazy with Widow, you're going to absolutely dominate these mobbies. And as we saw, Axiom just got that first pick, and what a grapple. Absolutely knocking their tank
absolutely
back.
Bonkers, crazy. Got behind him, it was an uppercut onto the Winston player.
The amount of speed he's getting is absolutely insane. What a crash too, using it to his advantage to get up onto the bridge, pushing the whole team back into their spawn.
My goodness, he's still alive. Axiom gets the kill. Slat does fall on the backside, but he'll come right back up with the Mejia res.
You're gonna see Candle Queen tank for that res. Almost dies, but pops his shield so he can get away. We're gonna see Camden kind of back up a little bit so they can get that robot up.
And Axiom has picked off the Moira two times. The Moira barely has even gotten an opportunity to play.
And it's just, I mean, for Manchester, it's gotta be annoying, you know? Like, their whole team getting knocked back, and as soon as they get a pick, just instantly getting rez. Meanwhile, their tank is tanking for the rez. It's just an endless loop of, you know, tanking, getting pushed back, getting a pick, getting it rez, and getting pushed back again, and it just keeps going on.
He's got another angle here. Jaehyun does go down. This could be an opportunity.
Duels, in fact.
Axiom fishing for something. He'll get it. Paleface off the board.
Trying to grapple away from that Winston. Is he going to get away? He almost does.
But at what cost? Candle Queen taking out Toasty, the Genji off the board. And this has kind of been an interesting one, Aiden. There's been a lot of kills off the backside of these fights. Been a little disjointed.
And here he goes again, absolutely knocking back everybody. Splitting them up so the heals cannot heal each other. Almost gets picked off there, but managed to go and grab a heal. I see Axiom trying to get some picks off. There was a recent buff for all projectile sizes. They all did get buffed quite a bit. So all those aim characters like Hanzo and Cassidy and Widow, as we're seeing, is just absolutely deadly with his headshots. And he gets a pick onto their Lucio.
And that's really what we've seen. It's been a pick onto the support, which has been the go button for Camden County. As we say that, it's been Manchester.
He's playing ring around the rosy right now. That instant damage, almost picking off. He's going to get this pick, I think.
Oh, it definitely will. Yeah, Paleface goes away. No supports available, so Manchester's going to have to run from the hills as Axiom has the kill onto Toasty.
We're seeing Camden do a great job of kind of holding their ground after one of them gets picked off.
This forward control here would be huge for Camden County. It's certainly within striking distance.
We're seeing Camden County kind of sit back and wait for that. And then the guy to get a little bit more aggressive so he can push him all the way back to their spot. He's rearing to go. And here he goes. Flying into the air, crashing down onto all of them.
How is the air up there? Had the hang time on that one.
It's just so enjoyable to see people play Hammy this well. I think Jaehyun gets some great damage in with Reaper. Let's get this barricade moving. Jaehyun getting a pick, going in and locking him in that room. We're seeing two ults go out on the side of Manchester, but we're just not able to do much. Toasty getting two, but that insta res right after the pick.
Insta res, and it's been even, but like you said before, Aiden, when you've got the Mercy here, as the ult comes down.
We're seeing their Winston get soloed off. We see all of their attention rotates off onto that Winston. You see Manchester frantically throwing out all these ults, but they just can't seem to do anything with them.
No, I think, and again, we saw the Genji ultimate come out. To your point, it didn't heal very much at all.
I mean, yeah, he got the two picks, but it was only half effective because they got that Mercy Grizz off. Came to try to take back this robot. This boy were going in trying to pick off Jehoon, and they managed to do it.
Well, Paleface there with a great play. Actually, it's a triple kill for Manchester, so they're still very much alive here.
He can look when he's trying to be as annoying as possible, hiding behind every angle he can, and then going in and getting a little bit of damage. Looks like he's trying to find a place to grapple on, and he is. The amount of airtime he's getting right now is absolutely insane!
The wombo combo, it was set up by Candle Queen. It was put home by Jehoon.
That synergy is just absolutely insane. As you said, Candle Queen throwing them all up sky high and Jehoon picking them all away with his ultimate. And he's just knocking their Winston in and out, in and out.
Hey, you're absolutely right. It has to be, it's just totally annoying, right? I mean, the disruption can be felt from here.
I mean, they're pretty much just playing knockback. They've got the right click of the Lucio just to push people back. Then they've got the Hammy to just knock them all back.
We did see Lucio ultimate get wasted there. Unfortunately, Slap trying to save himself, not able to do it.
4 minutes left on the clock. The robot is being pushed back on the side of Manchester. Candle Queen and Lucio kind of going at it. He's gonna heal up before going back in. Manchester realized they were pushed up way too far and regrouped.
The Cougars will get an opportunity to stop the momentum before this push really gets going. Any pick will be huge.
I'm kind of seeing everybody kind of just sticking with their team comps right now.
Cobra Maestro goes low as to Zero and a supporting tank gone.
There he goes, speeding back onto their side, knocking them all back. Axiv coming in as well, getting those picks. He's gonna knock back to Genji into the room. Unfortunately, unable to get the pick. Axiv has a crazy angle here, getting good damage in. Gonna grapple up, try to get a better advantage point.
Ooh,
almost picks off Paleface once again.
Tries to dunk. But he might get dunked on, it does. But they trade it right back! DPS 4 support!
There you see two DPS holes on the side, and there's one. And he managed to get another pick. Two DPS holes on the side of Manchester. Get two picks once again.
Mejia being alive here is huge. It will definitely keep this defense alive for the at least for the moment.
See there, Winston try and just pick off their Meja, but she's just running away and they can't do anything. Mercy movement is insane. As we said, they're just a mobility team and they're using it to their advantage.
Family Guy and Candle Queen playing a dangerous game of Ring Around the Rosy. Who is gonna have the DPS? Neither player going
down.
And
it looks like he's gonna absolutely slam him. He's gonna solo ult him, actually. He saw the Winston coming back and knew he had to back off. Gonna go for a heal.
Bit of a misstep there from Candle Queen. You called it. I mean, it's the solo ultimate doesn't yield anything except maybe the ability to retreat.
I mean, as we've seen, he's been able to push him back, so he's maybe coming up with a crazy plan to push them all back into him. They're gonna see Jehoon come out with an ultimate here. No picks, except on the Toasty. Winston jumps all the way back onto Axiv.
Gets away, gets to the support, the heal's coming through.
But we see their tank go down.
I think we will. Zero so low,
but
alive.
Away, but unfortunately, just cannot. The Reaper's stuck back in a corner. As we see again, just getting knocked back into a corner. Their Moira comes back to help. He's not going to be able to get away, though.
Manchester's not been able to get any momentum. It has been this corridor every single time that they have just been stopped.
Think about it, it's just a god lineup. They've got the pushback from Slat and Candle Queen. They've got Jehoon to handle up the close quarters, and they've got Axiv holding the back lines with the sniper, and then Meja just absolutely dominating with all those saves and heals with that Mercy mobility. Again, just rezzing as well as when Manchester gets a pick.
Well, a flanking opportunity here. We also saw Zero pop the Winston ultimate, so Axiv off the board. Manchester looks to turn things around once again.
Another ult already from Jehoon. Actually, he just used it about like 20, 30 seconds ago.
Oh, he's going to be in position here. Aiden with ultimate available. Only 15 seconds remaining. I'm sure we're going to see it.
He manages to slip away.
Lucio gone. Now it is a 5v4, making it a 5v3. And no more time for Manchester. It's put up or shut up time.
You can see Jaehoon just holding onto that ult. He's going to try to see where he's ulting to counteract it, but it just does not matter.
And by the way, Axiv with the kill on the ulting Genji.
And there's Jaehoon to kind of pull them back. Absolutely insane. I have a feeling I know where play of the game's gonna go. Once again to Jaehoon.
We'll see. I wonder. It might be Axiv. I'm going Axiv here. Maybe at the very end?
Oh, it's going to Candle Queen.
All right.
Oh, it's. I think I know where it is. Yeah, it's just kind of push him back. Not the greatest play we've seen, but there were definitely some more interesting ones, but I mean, that's Overwatch for you, kind of just, you know, giving you those weird little play the games, even though you've seen some better ones.
Right, it's never the one you expect. I mean, yeah. Listen, I feel like, correct me if I'm wrong, but I feel like if you could just give it to the DPS player every single time, pretty much, sometimes the tank. I feel like they've built into the game to allow, like, supports to get it once in a while. I don't know. That's just me. Maybe it's a conspiracy theory. But regardless, Aiden, map number 4 now, the reverse sweep is alive. So we head into map 5. What do you think?
Well, we're seeing a great comeback from the Cougars right now. I mean, Manchester's struggling right now to figure out what to do against that hamster ball. They just can't seem to counteract it. And then we have Jaehoon and Axiv playing off each other super well. Slat also getting in that great knockback damage with Lucio. His Lucio movement is insane. And then Meha with the Mercy is just saving everybody and getting those res off is, like, insane.
Well, they certainly seem to have found their composition, so it's up to Manchester now. We've seen the wrinkles and the adjustments from Camden County. Now it's up to Manchester as we head into Map 5. So everyone stay tuned for that. We'll have it for you in just a minute.
back to map 5. We are looking at a very intense match right now. Both Manchester and Camden, 2-2. This is match point.
Match point, and, you know, taking a look at the team compositions, at least to start, and, you know, things can change. But Kato Queen still sticking with the hamster here. Now we see Jaehoon switching to McCree. What I think is the biggest change, at least for Camden County, a Family Guy switching to the Zenyatta, Zero onto the D.Va.
Zenyatta's a very great counter to hamster ball, but I don't know how that's going to work out for them, but we'll see. We are seeing a Tracer as well, so they might be trying to pick off, you know, of course, the person who's sitting back, and in this case, Jaehoon. Looks like right now, he goes in for the slam, pushing everybody out of the way and getting that great pick. Once again, he's just finding these great spots to just sit at and then jumps down. You saw Zero try to go up to try to kill Jaehoon, but just was not able to get all the way up.
Huge plays, but it's going to be kills like the one that Paleface just got on Slat that's going to hurt just a little bit more, but Slat back at it.
You see Kano Queen pushing him all the way back into their spawn, literally forcing Manchester to go around to the side.
Ooh!
Jaehoon with those crazy shots.
And Candle Queen's cleaning it up, and then stalking Zero, and Zero is off the board. And this is now oppressive. Candle Queen just on top of Manchester.
And he gets a pick onto Toasty as well. Candle Queen is dominating this match right now. Doesn't look like Manchester's gonna make any team swaps. They're just gonna keep trying to go with it.
No, might be waiting for an ultimate or something like that to try and get a pick, open up, and split the defense, but it hasn't happened yet.
They found out Candle Queen's position. Is Candle Queen gonna jump all the way back down?
And that slam,
it doesn't look like they needed Jaehoon with two picks.
Wow, and before the attack can even get started, Aiden, it has short-circuited once again.
D.Va Met goes down, D.Va gets picked, same with Baptiste. This is just wow. They're just holding them in their spawn. They can't even leave.
And now it's going to be four ultimates on the side of Camden County as Camel Queen takes his perch and just waits for his time to strike. Like a trapdoor spider, but from above. We'll call that an attic spider. It's the only thing I could think of as the opposite of a trapdoor.
The accident getting ready here like an eagle looking down at his prey, ready to pounce. He's jumping down after Candle Queen has gone in and jumped in. Zero's gonna ult. Actually looking for a way to escape. He manages to get away.
Free ultimate as well. Candle Queen falls off the side, so that could prove a little scary. A lot of ultimates used.
Ult here maybe, trying to hold back. It looks like he doesn't need it though. Picking off Zero's mech and picking off Zero and Jaehoon backing him up.
Thanks, Doc.
As we know, Hammy is just great for getting back to points super fast, so Candle Queen's gonna be back there in no time. As we can see, he's already back up on his roof. It's like a trap almost. They're just like ambushing him from the roofs. They can't really do anything.
Yeah, I mean, so we see the Ana come out. Will that really be the difference? I mean, maybe for the sleep here onto the ball?
Again, crashes down and gets the Zen. He knows that the Zen is his counter, so he's getting rid of him first.
They just don't have an answer for the ball here. A slat does go down, but Mejia likely to get him right back up.
Looks like they are trying to go for it. Axiv and Candle Queen with good picks. Jaehoon with a great damage. I mean, they're also kind of swap. Axiv and Jaehoon last match were going Axiv on range and Jaehoon on close range. They kind of swap it up. As we can see, they're all kind of laughing about how they're just going back under the roofs and do the same thing over and over again.
I mean, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. The Pharah comes out, but I think it's too little too late.
Matter. Absolutely stomped. This is just absolute slaughter right now.
A total bloodbath. You're absolutely right. And it's just going to be a couple of players here to try and keep things alive, but Family Guy goes away. Cancel that TV show. But unless, I think that's going to be it.
Great shot on a Toasty. That's what we like to see, those hit scan players. And there it is, round one complete. absolute wipeout from Camden County.
By the way, I'm not a hater of Family Guy, the TV show. I was just, you know, as I do, Aiden, I try and find a good pun as I'm casting. More of a Simpsons guy, at least early on in my childhood. I might be dating myself. Here's a fun fact, Aiden. The Simpsons are as old as I am. They started almost exactly around the time I was born.
I remember as a kid always, you know, waiting. My mom would not allow me to watch The Simpsons or Family Guy as a kid. Because, you know, it popped up on those late night parts of the Cartoon Network
and all
that stuff.
Right. Well, and also, you know, it's teaching kids to do some, you know, things like, you know, I don't know, like punch their sister or something like that, right? Some stuff like that. Well, I mean, the Cougars don't need to do much here on their own attack run. They basically need to get only a foothold, only an edge in a team fight will yield them a map 5 victory.
I mean, as we can see, it's a very versatile team. They only need to switch up to Sojourn so they can get a little bit more aggressive. We are seeing a completely different setup from Manchester. We're seeing Sigma, Lifeweaver, Mercy, Sombra, and Reaper. Completely different team comp from what they've been playing.
Well, Candle Queen not getting off of the hamster ball at all. Not surprising.
I'm glad they're staying. I just am enjoying watching them absolutely destroy. As we can see, Candle Queen goes straight for that Mercy.
Does get hacked, but again, the Cougars just need to pretty much get one pick, and that's really all they'll need.
We are seeing action, trying to get that damage in. Swapping out for Candle Queen. Candle Queen does go down.
But traded right back.
Trade.
And that's a one for one, but he is going to get Candle Queen up as well. Possibly. Does. So these even trades are always going to favor Camden County.
That hamster is back up. We can see he's going for that Lifeweaver. Lifeweaver knows he's going to get chased. We can see the Sombra and Lifeweaver try to counter against him. Pushed into the wall. Oh, but it gets hacked before he can slam onto the ground.
Now this composition seems built just to neutralize Candle Queen a little bit. But again, at what cost?
I mean, they've gotten their Mercy, and Lifeweaver's stuck trying to 1v1 with Candle Queen. I mean, there's just nothing they can do. One of the healers is occupied, and they're just not getting enough heals.
Manchester giving it everything they have here, but it's just too much. You'd have to be actually truly perfect to be able to match the Cougars.
Comeback from the Cougars. See if we're playing the game here. We are going to see Cassidy.
Yeah, we'll see the play of the game here for just a second. He's giving it to the DPS players.
A solo wall is crazy. I mean, that was just a clean sweep those last three games. I honestly am speechless. I don't know what to say.
You don't really expect a turnaround like that. I mean, the Cougars, let's set the scene for anyone that might be watching here. I think it's pretty clear, but I think it's just in case. I think that the Cougars started with some of their sub players. We have a full, I think there's 8 members of the Overwatch team. I think all 8 actually got a chance to play tonight. So the subs started. And then slowly the starters came back in, and that's what we saw certainly for maps 3, 4, and 5. So, you know, a little bit different. You usually see it sometimes in reverse, Aiden, where you get a good lead and then the subs can come in and get some time, but done differently. And the result is all the same. And I just love seeing all 8 of them come out here in a game.
I mean, yeah, I'm on the Valorant team, but we always try to incorporate our subs into the games, try to get them, you know, not feel left out. So try to get him some experience, but also helps with kind of fixing synergies that need to be worked on, especially with new people. But as we saw, that they kind of picked it up in the last half once they got back to their original team, and it's just they wiped the floor.
They did. They looked very comfortable. So it's great to see. We're going to take a small break. We're hoping to have a player interview, as we like to do, especially on the victories. So stay tuned for that, and we'll have a player here in just a couple of minutes.